one sentence. I want you to notice from this that what you're talking, what we're hearing here is not the language of realism, which is a reluctant acceptance of killers. It is an endorsement of
them. And who were the killers before 1992?
That's the motion
before the House. The apologists for Israel have always blamed everyone but themselves.
Okay.
Before Hamas ever existed, there was another killer.
Okay. It is not reluctant acceptance, it is endorsement.
Can we just let each other speak, please? And can we move on to a question from you, sir?
What will Hamas gain from not renouncing violence and from denying the fact of the Israeli government? What will this help them in the end of the road? Well, will it change the fact of what's happening?
The fact of the matter is both Musa Abu Marzouk and Ismail Haniyeh said today that, look, we will discuss the issue of the existence, the right of existence of Israel at a point and at a time. But at this particular time, we are occupied. We are under occupation. We are a resistance movement. People have asked us to represent them in struggling against the resistance movement. What Israel wants and what the West wants is guarantees of security before they end the occupation. Hamas has been very clear. The Arab League in 2002 spoke, and Hamas has joined on to that position. Roll back to 1967, and it's over. There's a resolution. So, to the degree that you ask Hamas to renounce violence, great. I would advise Hamas to renounce violence when Israel announces violence.
A question, I'll come back on that.
But do you think that this will help, you know, end the occupation of Israeli people, to Palestinian people?
I'm less concerned about what they
think?
Say than what they do.
What do you think, actually? Do you think it's going
to
help?
I think in the end that Hamas will have to renounce violence, and the funding is going to not come back until they do. And no one will identify Hamas as a political party from the Western people like today unless they do.
I'm less concerned with the rhetoric of government than what happens on the ground. George Bush was against nation building. Where are we in Iraq? We're in Iraq all of a sudden for nation building. Governments historically make broad pronouncements that are rhetoric.
Anybody else from the audience? Do you want to come back one more time?
This problem has to be resolved by renouncing violence, because violence will never do any good for Hamas especially, because the Israelis are not going to just leave. With violence, without violence, in both ways, the Israelis are going
to
stay.
Okay, thank you very much. There's a lady behind you who wants to ask a question. Thank you.
This question is for the members of the panel against the motion. Isn't democracy allowing the people to make their own decisions? So if the Palestinians have chosen, why should the international community, and especially the West, who keeps talking about democracy, interfere?
Yeah, Salim Mansour, let me ask you first.
Governments are, in a democratic society, the representative of the people. And so most Western democracies have to be in tune with their own people and their own people. I'm coming from Canada, and the Canadians are debating this issue, and the Canadians are not satisfied that the Hamas, subsidizing Hamas, is in the interest of Canada. And I assume that's what most of the Western democracies are faced with. This is the learning process. Now the Palestinians have to learn and will learn through the democratic processes that their decisions have consequences. They have elected Hamas, so we respect the Palestinians' choice.
So,
but that doesn't mean that we'll turn around and respect their outcome.
We can't see that. We can't see that they respect it. We can't see that the Westerners respect the choice of the
David Frum, did you want to come in on this?
I want to say I concur exactly with Professor Smith that you asked why do governments represent their people. The American government represents the people of the United States. The governments of Europe represent their people. The partnership that Hamas is, that this resolution discusses, which is not a partnership that Hamas has asked for, is about a flow of money in excess of $1 billion a year from the United States to the European Union. That's what Hamas wants to see continue. That the voters of the Palestinian Authority can elect the government they want, but they cannot vote for the foreign aid policies of the United States and Europe. And the United States and Europe would be wise not to give money into the hands of people who, as Mr. Cohen said, where there is no difference between the so-called civilians and the terrorist wing, and a party that is committed to war in the Middle East and to the annihilation of the state
Hamas
of Israel.
Hamas is not asking for anything from the West right now. It is the West that is trying to impose, for its own selfish strategic priorities, their rule on Hamas.
You want
Hamas's
the money,
position,
the terms.
Keep the money. Somehow I suspect the Palestinian people who have survived everything since 1948 will do fine without your money. Somehow I suspect the Palestinians
will survive. Are they going to go for Iran's money? Are they going to go for Syrian money?
Maybe they'll do a fundraiser on television like Jerry Lewis does a telethon.
Isn't that the
Maybe
risk
every
David
Palestinian
Trump
in the world will develop, throw in $2. They don't need your money.
David Frum, okay. Isn't the risk if you cut off the money that they'll look to Iran? You don't want that happening, do you?
But they already receive money from Iran, and they already receive money, in fact, from sponsors of terror throughout the region. But understand that is this relationship of partnership. Hamas is not asking for partnership. They are asking for war.
You don't take know their, what they're
could,
asking
Could you let him finish, please?
Take their charter seriously. Take their own, give them at least this respect of taking their own words seriously. And I think there is a gap here between the two people on the opposing side, because I think one does know, I think Mr. Cohen really does know, they're not kidding, they are serious. Now, his partner is not so sure. He's hoping they'll change, they don't mean it.
But do you want to speak for yourself here?
Give them the credit of believing they do, and what they mean is war and danger for you, and that is what you're being asked to vote for.
Okay, Dr. Mohamedou, do you want
to
come in?
Thank you very much, Mr. Frum, for trying to divide.